Hello friends, today I am going to discuss about DEPT under C13 NMR. So what is DEPT? Full name of DEPT is distortionless enhancement by polarization transfer. This video is sponsored by GPAT Discussion Center. They provide online test series for GPAT, NIPER, drug inspector and a pharmacist, job alerts, admission alerts, pharma news and many more. Regular classes, dedicated GDC app for users. Link for detail is given in the description. So you can visit gdcforgpat.com for details. So this DEPT technique is mainly used to differentiate between primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary carbon atoms. In DEPT technique, sequence of pulses with various delay time is used to create the DEPT spectra. Now coming to the difference between normal C13 spectra and a DEPT spectra. So in C13 spectra, all types of carbon atoms will be visible, means spectra of all carbon atoms will be visible in normal C13 spectra. But in DEPT, quaternary carbon atoms will not be visible. So by using DEPT, we can differentiate between primary, secondary and tertiary carbon atom with quaternary carbon atom. So in this DEPT technique, sample will be irradiated by electromagnetic radiation of different angle of pulses. So these different angle of pulses are three types. First one is 45 degree, second one is 90 degree and the third one is 135 degree. Now coming to the details about DEPT. So if we are talking about C13 NMR, so in C13 NMR all spectra of carbon will be visible. So in C13 NMR, all spectra of carbons will be visible, means primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary, all types of carbon atoms will be visible in C13 NMR spectra. Now coming to this one, DEPT spectra. So DEPT spectra is categorized into three categories, that is DEPT 45, DEPT 90 and DEPT 135. So if we are talking about DEPT 45, then this DEPT 45 will give the signal of primary, secondary and tertiary carbon atom, means it will not give any spectra of quaternary carbon atom. Now if we are talking about DEPT 90, then it will give the signal of only CH carbon atoms, means it will give signal of only tertiary carbon atoms. Now coming to the third one, which is DEPT 135. So DEPT 135 is categorized into two categories. First one is upward and second one is downward. Upward is known as positive signal and downward is known as negative signal. So primary and tertiary carbon atom will give the upward signal and the secondary carbon atom will give the downward signal. So these are the two categories of DEPT 135. Here you can see that one is positive and one is negative. What is the meaning of positive and negative? If you are taking the baseline like this, So primary and tertiary signal will come upside like this, and this negative value or secondary carbon atom will give the signal in the downside like this. Okay, so it will be negative and this will be positive. Now I am taking one example for better understanding of this DPT, and that example is like this. So here you can see that in this example 6 carbons are present, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and here you can see that both these carbons are present in the same environment, means both are equivalent carbon. So it will give total 5 signal, that is A, B, C, D and E. So this CH3 will give the signal A, this carbon will give the B, this CH2 will give the signal C, this carbon CH will give the signal D, and this CH3 and CH3 will give the signal A. Now if we are talking about simple C13 NMR, then it will give total 5 signals and it will be like this. So it is giving 5 signals, that is A, B, C, D and E. This is simple representation because here I have not considered electronegativity of the atoms, that is why directly I am taking A, B, C, D, E. Now after that we will take the example of DPT45. So in DPT45 it gives the spectra primary, secondary and tertiary carbon atoms. So it will not give the spectra of quaternary carbon atoms. So this B1 is quaternary carbon atom. So in DPT45 we will not get the signal for this C double bond O carbon, and the spectra will be like this. So this DPT45 will give the 4 signal, that is A, C, D and E. Now coming to the next one, which is DPT90. So here it is written that it gives the spectra of only CH carbon atom. So in this structure only one CH atom is present, that is D. So it will give the signal of only D. So when we will do the DPT90, then it will give only one signal, that is only for D. Now coming to the next one, which is DPT135. So here it is written that primary and tertiary carbon atom will give the positive signal and the secondary carbon atom will give the negative signal. So here we will get the signal of this A, then this E, both will be upward, means positive, and we will get the signal of D. This D signal will also be in positive side, and we will get the signal of this C, and this signal will be in the negative side, but we will not get the signal of B. So here you can see the signal of A, D and E are coming upward because they are positive, and signal of C is coming downward because it is negative. So by using all these 4 spectra, we can easily identify primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary carbon atom. If we will compare the spectra of C13 NMR and DPT45, so we can easily identify the spectra of B, that is C double bond O. Now coming to the next spectra, which is DPT90. So here you can easily identify this spectra is for CH, that is for tertiary carbon atom. And the last one is DPT-135. So by observing this spectra, we can easily identify primary and secondary carbon atoms. So here this spectra is coming in this also and in this also. So CH is identified, and here C is coming downward, means in negative side. So this spectra is for this CH2 group, so it will be identified. And the remaining spectra, that is A and E, so both these spectra will be for CH3 or for primary carbon atom, because if it will be for tertiary carbon atom, so it may occur here, but it is not showing spectra in this DPT-90. It means A and E spectra is for primary carbon atom. So this is the details about DPT spectra under C13 NMR. Thank you.